Now, last time we have seen, we have completed the wave theory of light. Wave theory was started by Huygens and it was completed by Maxwell. So, this wave theory has certain merits. It can explain so many phenomena. Even though wave theory can explain so many phenomena, it has drawbacks shown by the new phenomena of light discovered in 19th century. So, what are these phenomena? Now, if we list the phenomena of light, then the list is like this: rectilinear propagation, reflection, I will write down short form. Reflection or refraction, dispersion, double refraction, interference. Diffraction, polarization, simultaneous reflection refraction or partial reflection refraction, this is group D. Now, in 19th century, some new phenomena has been discovered. I will make the another group, B group, new phenomena, modern phenomena, that is photoelectric effect. Photoelectric effect, Compton effect, Raman effect, like this. So these are the three effects, newly discovered phenomena: photoelectric effect, Compton effect, Raman effect, etc. So these are the total phenomena of light known today. So why I have made two groups, A and B? The reason is this. The phenomena from group A can be explained even today satisfactorily by using wave nature of light. Wave nature of light. And these three phenomena are explained by using particle nature. These particles are called as photon nature, particle nature of light. So, what is the main point? This particle nature cannot be used to explain any one phenomena from group A. Wave nature cannot be used any one phenomena from group B. So, for this phenomena, this is the wave nature that we have to assume. For this phenomena, we have to consider particle nature of light. This nature cannot be used here, this nature cannot be used here. But nowadays, all these phenomena are known and they are explained well. So, what is the conclusion? Some phenomena of light are explained by considering wave nature. Light travels in the form of transverse electromagnetic wave. Some phenomena are explained by using particle nature, light travels in the form of photons. And therefore, what conclusion we can draw? Nowadays, we have accepted that light has both wave nature as well as particle nature. And it has both nature, therefore it is called as a dual nature of light. So this is the final conclusion that we have obtained. Nowadays we use both type of nature, wave nature as well as the पर्टिक्युलर नेचर. मग आता जरी दोघे नेचर असले तरी कुठला नेचर यूज करत आहे ते कशावर डिपेंड आहे, इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द फेनॉमेना. जर ह्या ग्रुपमधले फेनॉमेना प्रूव्ह करायचे असेल तर लाईटचा वेव्ह नेचर एक्सप्लेन करा, या ग्रुपमधले फेनॉमेना एक्सप्लेन करायचे असेल तर पर्टिक्युलर नेचर यूज करा. सो दिस इज मीन्स ड्युअल नेचर. ड्युअल मीन्स बोथ लाईट बिहेव लाईक वेव फॉर दिस ग्रुप, लाईट बिहेव लाईक पर्टिकल फॉर दिस अनदर ग्रुप. So light has both type of nature, wave nature as well as particle nature, and that is called as the dual nature of light. So what do you mean by dual nature? The explanation is like this. Since some phenomena of light are explained using wave nature, while remaining phenomena are explained by considering particle nature. So what conclusion we can draw? Therefore, light behaves like waves as well as particles therefore light has both nature, both the natures. This is called dual nature of light. So this is the conclusion. Light behaves like waves as well as like particles. Therefore, light has both the nature. Therefore, it is called as a dual nature. So we have accepted this nature like this. So this is about the final conclusion about the nature of the light. So dual nature is accepted nowadays. So now we have accepted that light has both type of nature. In this chapter, wave optics, to explain so many phenomena, reflection, refraction, interference, diffraction, polarization, etc. We are going to consider the wave nature, light as a wave, light as a transverse electromagnetic wave. So this assumption, light travels in the form of wave, is used to explain phenomena, then it is called as the wave optics. So now we can give the definition of wave optics. Definition of wave optics. The definition is given like this. It is the branch of optics. Optics has two sub branches. One is the ray optics and other is the wave optics. It is the branch of the physics which uses the wave nature of light to explain the optical phenomena is called as. So definition can be given like this. The branch of optics which uses wave nature of light to explain the optical phenomena. It's called wave optics. So this is the definition. The branch of optics which uses the wave nature. So we are using light as a wave, and therefore let us see some basic properties of light. Actually light चे भरपूर property आपण electromagnetic वेव्हच्या topic मध्ये बघितलेले आहे. Properties of light or wave nature, you can say wave nature. Properties of light or properties of wave nature. So in this case our assumption is like this. Light is an electromagnetic wave. So we know the property of the electromagnetic wave. They can travel through vacuum also without a medium. Therefore, light does not require any medium for their propagation. And can travel through vacuum also without medium. In vacuum, light travels with the greatest speed c equal to 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. For any other medium, the speed of the light depends on certain factor. It depends upon the refractive index of the medium like this. For medi, other than vacuum, speed of light filter but depends on a refractive index n of the medium and n is equal to, we know this property, it is equal to 1 upon under root mu 0 mu and epsilon 0, that is n depends on permittivity epsilon and permeability mu of the medium. So speed of light depends upon the type of the medium, the refractiveness of the medium, and refractiveness in turn depends upon the permittivity and permeability. So if we substitute this as a 4 pi into 10 into minus 1 and epsilon is equal to 1 upon 4 pi into 10 into minus 8, then this C is given 1. So we have verified this value. This value comes to be, for vacuum it comes to be 3 into 10 into 8 meter per second, like this. So for any other medium it is given like this. So speed of light depends on speed C depends on the permittivity, like this. So these are the properties of the light that we are going to use, like this. So we have accepted wave nature of light, and wave nature has this basic property. अजून एक प्रॉपर्टी आपल्याला माहिती आहे, त्याची फ्रिक्वेन्सी रेंज, त्याचं स्पेक्ट्रम वगैरे, इनव्हिजिबल लाईटचं स्पेक्ट्रम वगैरे, रेड टू व्हायलेट एटसेट्रा. सो दिस इज द वेव नेचर दॅट वी हॅव एक्सेप्टेड. नाव युझिंग दिस वेव नेचर वी टू एक्सप्लेन सम फेनॉमेना, बट बिफोर दॅट वी टू सी सम न्यू टर्म्स रिलेटेड विथ द वेव्स. ऑलरेडी वी नो सम टर्म्स, एम्प्लिट्यूड, फ्रिक्वेन्सी, पिरियड, wavelength, etc. Now we have to consider two new terms. One is a wavefront and other is a wave normal. So for our further discussion we are going to consider this wavefront and wave normal. So before going to the wavefront and wave normal, first we have to consider what is meant by phase. Because while defining the wavefront, we require the concept of same phase that we have seen earlier in the last year. The same phase चा meaning बघण्याच्या अगोदर आपल्याला phase चा meaning माहिती पाहिजे. So in the chapter SHM oscillation, chapter number 5, we have already considered the term phase in detail. So same concept can be used here. So before going to the new term wavefront and wave normal, we will consider what is meant by phase of a wave. Phase of a wave. So you can give the definition like this. This is the important part for this chapter. The phase of a wave at a given point describes the state of motion of the particle at that point. Spread the motion of the particle at that point, and it gives the state of motion, and also it gives one more point as well as distance covered. Distance of a point from distance of that point from the source of light, source of wave, like this. So this is the definition. Now, what is meant by state of motion? State of motion means magnitude and direction of displacement of an oscillating particle. Medium. So when the wave passes through a medium, every particle starts vibrating about its mean position. So that property of oscillator motion we have already studied in oscillation. Now, also it indicates the distance of that point. How? Phase of the wave is denoted by phi. Phase of a wave phi is an angle which also gives the number of oscillations, number of oscillations completed by the particle, number of oscillation capital N, like this. So this is the meaning of the phase of the wave. So when the two particles are vibrating in the same phase, then they have same state of motion, means they have same velocity and displacement perpendicular to the wave surface, and they are at the same distance from the source. For example, when two particles of the medium are vibrating in same phase, then they are vibrating in the same phase, then they have same velocity, mean direction of and magnitude of velocity, direction and magnitude of the displacement, they have both are vector quantity. they have same velocity and displacement and are at same distance from the source. Therefore, phase difference between them, is 0, 2 pi radian, 4 pi radian, 6 pi radian, 8 pi radian. So phase difference is denoted by delta phi. So delta phi is equal to 2 pi multiplied by 2m, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. That is even multiple of even multiple of 2 pi radian, like this. So this is the mathematical expression for same phase, like this. Now opposite phase, the many point of the same phase. So what is mean by same phase and what is mean by opposite phase, that we have to explain first. So to explain the concept of same phase, we are going to consider this type of arrangement. So actually amplitude should remain constant. Like this. So on y axis we are plotting the value of displacement plus y minus y. On x-axis we are considering the value of phi, phase, angle. So the values are like this: 0 degree already given here, 90 degree, path pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, 2 pi, 2 pi plus pi by 2 means 5 pi by 2, 3 pi, this is 7 pi by 2, 4 pi. Nine pi by 2, then 10 pi by 2 means 5 pi, 11 pi by 2 and 6 pi, etc. So these are the values of phase angle in radian. So this position is called the crust. 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 So C1, G2, C3, C4 are crust. And this is trough. T1, T2, T3, T4, etc. Crust C1, C2, C3, C4, etc. have फेज एंगल पाई बाय रूट 90 डिग्री पाई बाय रूट 9 पाई बाय रूट थर्टीन पाई बाय टू एटसेट्रा. सो फेज डिफरेंस बिटवीन टू सक्सेसिव क्रस्ट इज इक्वल टू 2 पाई एंगल इधर एन की वैल्यू जीरो डाला फेज डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू सक्सेसिव क्रस्ट इज इक्वल टू 2 पाई रेडियन देयरफॉर ऑल द क्रस्ट आर वाइब्रेटिंग इन सेम फेज ऑल द क्रस्ट आर वाइब्रेटिंग इन सेम फेज. Case number one. For crust C1 and trough T1, directions of velocity and displacements. Are opposite. Therefore, they are vibrating in opposite phase are 180 degrees out of phase. 180 degree out of phase because phase difference between them is equal to 180 degree. So from figure this is the important rule. From figure for crust in first wave, first cycle, phi is 90 degree. For trough in first cycle, phase phi is equal to 270 degree. Therefore, crust, trough are in same phase, having phase difference zero or 360 degree or 720 degree or 1080 degree etc. Crust and trough are in opposite phase having phase difference equal to 180 degree. Either 360 add kala 540 degree. Either puna 360 add kala 900 degree etc. Niche pan difference 2 pi jana 180 degree 540 900 etc. And 0 360 etc. So which particles are in same phase? which are in opposite field, that can be given like this. So if we consider these two crust, both are moving in the same direction, both are at distance equal to amplitude, so magnitude is same, direction is same, like this one. Same magnitude, same direction, same velocity, they are vibrating in the same phase. Same magnitude but opposite direction, they are in opposite phase. So this is the meaning of same phase and opposite phase, like this. So in a wave, remember this, the crust has phase always 90 degree, the trough has phase 270 degree. तर एका सायकलमध्ये क्रस्ट आणि ट्रफच्या फेजेस याप्रमाणे आपण कन्सिडर करणार आहोत, लक्षात. नेक्स्ट सायकलमध्ये क्रस्टची फेज 2π ने इन्क्रीज होऊन जाईल, 90 + 360 जर केला तर तो 455 होऊन जाईल, लाईक दिस. सो दिस इज द मिनिंग ऑफ सेम फेज. इफ द टू पार्टिकल्स आर हॅविंग सेम वेलॉसिटी अँड सेम डिस्प्लेसमेंट, देन दे आर व्हायब्रेटिंग इन द सेम फेज. डिस्टन्सेस सेम असतीलच असं नाही आहे. ॲक्च्युली डिस्टन्सची व्हॅल्यू नंबर ऑफ ऑसिलेशनवर डिपेंड असते. डिस्टन्स इज गिवन बाय एन टाईम लॅमडा, वेअर लॅमडा इज द वेव्हलेंथ, एन इज द नंबर ऑफ वेव्स, लाईक दिस. सो नाऊ युझिंग दिस हायगन्स प्रिन्सिपल टू एक्सटेंड द कन्सेप्ट ऑफ वेव फ्रंट अँड वेव नॉर्मल. सो wave front and wave normal. So these are the two new terms related with the wave that we have to see. But before going to this, let us revise the basic properties of the wave. One, what is meant by amplitude of wave? So the distance is called as amplitude. So already we know this definition, amplitude. The maximum displacement of the particle from its mean position is called as a amplitude. So we already know this definition, we have seen them 2 or 3 times. The second definition is period. Period of wave motion. Capital D. Definition. Time taken by a wave to complete one cycle of a wave is called period of wave motion. The similar term that we have seen period of particle motion. It is generated by TP. It is generated by TW. Definition. Time taken by an oscillating particle. To complete 1 vibration. One vibration is called period of particle motion. For wave motion, this is the important property. For wave, TP and TW are TP and TW are always TP is equal to TW always. Both have same period. Then frequency is a reciprocal of period. Frequency of a wave N or F, you can use anything more. Definition. Number of cycles of a wave completed in 1 second or per second is called frequency of the wave is called frequency of the wave. Frequency is always a reciprocal of period. Whatever type of wave, maybe longitudinal wave, maybe transverse wave, etc. Next, wavelength. वेवलेंथच्या दोन डेफिनेशन आपण गेल्या वर्षी बघितलेल्या आहेत. वेवलेंथ लॅम्डा, वेलॉसिटी व्ही इज इक्वल टू एक्स लॅम्डा, वेर एफ इज द फ्रिक्वेन्सी, लॅम्डा इज द वेवलेंथ. इट इज द डिस्टन्स बिटवीन द टू सक्सेसिव पार्टिकल वाइब्रेटिंग इन द सेम फेज. आता डेफिनेशन रिपीट करण्याची गरज नाही. नाउ यूजिंग दिस बेसिक डेफिनेशन वी टू एक्सप्लेन द टर्म्स वेवफ्रंट एंड wave normal. First we will see wave front and then we will go for wave normal. So next time we will see this definition. Okay, now we will stop here.